So there is money for Bolter. One of the last of them to go in. The starters there on top of the ladder. No sign of the red light whatsoever, but he released them regardless. And the stablemates the first to go. Bolter on the outside of Auto Spark. They'd left together right behind those Pacific Boxer, followed by Madam Kisses. They're not going overly hard whatsoever. And the roughie is back on the inside. Gotcha brings up the tail end of the field. So Bolter given a little more rein by Panama. Length and a half clear. Pacific Boxer pulling its way around the outside. They're just sauntering along for a 1,000-metre race. Over on the inside, Auto Spark. Spark is running third. Madam Kisses goes up next. A length and a half behind those is Gotcha. The sprint's about to go right on. Bolter, who they've backed, got away from Pacific Boxer very quickly. He stokes up the leader, Bolter, from Pacific Boxer. Down the outside, Madam Kisses is starting to run on. In behind those next of all, Auto Spark. Madam Kisses has got them, though. She dashed straight to the lead with 100 to go. Put pay to them, and you can certainly get to the queue and collect if you're on the mare. She's going to win with her ears pricked. She won it very comfortably. Madam Kisses beat Pacific Boxer, who came again. He gives the stallion Romola Quinella. Behind them on the inside, Bolter. Then further back is Auto Spark, and it's amongst the last of them home, bar the roughy Gotcha. Madam Kisses, too good here. Nice mare. She's got a bit of quality about her. Her fifth win in 13 runs. They seem to just saunter up there at the head of the field. But she sprinted straight over the top. Pacific Boxer got caught flat-footed when that dash went on. But he came again, a bit similar to his last run. And we wait for the full list of the details. But that was a walk in the park. Victoria Corver just turned the ignition off on the Rommel mare in the last 100. And she ambled down to the post. She's out of Lucetta. Raced by Ms. T. Jeffries, the estate of the late Keith Jeffries. Mike and Mrs. S. Lonning, trained by Donna Reardon. A nice result here for the families of the Reardons and Jeffries. Loddings, Victoria Corver with an armchair ride. Two Pacific Boxer also by Rommel. And gives Rommel a Quinella here in race number two for the day. Down at Ridgeport Farm. Of course, this spring, Gino Paletti and Peter Nucky. And third, number six, Auto Spark. Auto Spark, number six, has grabbed, I beg your pardon, number six, Bolter, has run third from five, Auto Spark. 1, 2, 6, and 5, the interim numbers, and a length by a length, the margins. Now, the time is 59.94, so they certainly did not go out there and set any records, and home in 33.88. 33.88, the closing sectional. So she's got 5 wins and 6 minor placings from 13 runs. It's a very, very good record for Madam Kisses, and she made that look so, so easy. Pacific Boxer second in out of Don't Tell Sue, Gino Paletti, Peter Nucky, third Bolter by Sessions out of Debang, Dion Luciani, Brad Parnham in front of the stablemate Auto Spark. Madam Kisses 480, she got out to be a luxury price, 225 Pacific Boxer SP. Race number three on the card, 1,200 metres for the three-year-olds at set weights at 4:04, and 7 will run in the next without changes. Here's Lockie Taylor downstairs, and that was about as easy a watch as we'll probably see all day.
You're not wrong, Darren, and winning trainer Donna Reardon joins me now. Donna, only the second start for Madam Kisses under your care. What have you learnt about her throughout this campaign?
Yeah, she probably needed the run first up. It was a really good run. Got beat by, obviously, a very good horse. She's improved obviously from the first run, and she just does tend to have a really short, sharp kick. So the only thing I said to Victoria was just short and sharp.
When William Pike jumps off, obviously punters are sometimes a little bit concerned, but you must have loved with the way that Victoria handled the horse and I guess just rode exactly to your instructions.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, it was we had to really up to ride, but when the weights come out, she got 60 kilos, and she's not a big horse. Probably a little bit unfair to be going around with 60 kilos, so Willie will get back on one day, but Vicky did a great job.
From here, do you keep her at the 1,000?
We do want to stretch her out at some stage, but I haven't actually looked to the next start. We'll just see how she pulls up and go from there.
Well done on the win.
Thank you very much.
There's Donna Reardon combining with Victoria Corver and Madam Kisses, and Vic's now joining Scotty.
She certainly is. Pretty handy pickup ride this, Vicky. Yeah, definitely. When you've got a claim, sometimes you get to jump on the fast ones.
And today, it looked like in the small field, it was always going to pan out quite nicely for you, sort of second half of the field, but only with 5 in it, so not far off the leaders.
Yeah, I was happy just to come out quiet, and if I was last, it's not the end of the world, like you say, 5 horse field, so I was happy where I was.
Probably one of the easier wins you've been aboard.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. I think she's a really honest mare. She tries her hardest, so I'm not sure hitting her would make much difference.
Speaking of honest mares, later on, seen Eclipse scratch during the week to save for Saturday. Looks like it's been a pretty smart move. It's a winnable race for her, for sure.
Yeah, definitely. We're a bit wary about stepping up to Saturday grade with her, but the outside barrier over 1,200 Wednesday was the deciding factor, so she's on the outside today as well, but at least there's a few less horses.
Fingers crossed for a double. Well done.
Thank you.
There's Victoria Corva combining with Donna Reardon and a Madam Kisses to take out race number 2.
Sometimes in dreams of it.